And everybody, welcome back to new weekly reading vlog. It's been a while because I weekly vlogged March, April, May, June, July, and August. I did weekly reading vlogs for 6 months and then I stopped because I got Scotland and things got busy. But May is my favorite month of the year. It's also my birthday month and it's Asian American and Pacific Islanders Heritage Month. I thought, why not bring back the weekly reading vlogs and tell you what I'm going to read this month. I'm only going to read books written by Asian authors. It's very exciting. I cannot wait to start my first book, and it's from Little Tokyo with Love. I received this book from Penguin Random House and it's being released on May 11th. This is the first one I'm reading because I want to make sure that I have read it before its release date. And it's more than 400 pages. It's 423 pages, so that's exciting. I know I read the synopsis when it was first announced and then it just left my brain. I had other things to think about. But yeah, I was really excited when Penguin Random House sent me an email asking if I wanted to receive a copy. It's fine, I'm fine. But yeah, it's a lovely floppy paperback, so I will be reading this in priority. Hopefully I can read it pretty fast. I have a deadline coming next week for one of my exams, so I have an essay to hand back on Tuesday, which is a lot of work. So I don't know if I will be reading much this week, and I have another deadline for the week after that. So we'll see. But I have a lot of small books, so I'm going to prioritize them. This one is a fluke. It's just because it's being released first and I want to make sure I have read it first. But yeah, so I don't know yet what I'm going to pick up this week. We will see. But yeah, I'm excited to do weekly reading vlogs once again. It was something I love to do. It helped me go through lockdown, honestly. So let's do it again. Also, we are May 1st. Obviously. It's, I don't know, wait, what time is it? It's 10:36 and I just made breakfast, some coffee. I had to wash the dishes and things like that. But yeah, I went to bed at 2:30 yesterday. I mean, today, technically. So I'm a bit exhausted, but I did some work. And that's pretty good because my deadline is in 2 days. Everything's fine. But wait, we are chaotic today. Do you want to know how many pages I read of Little Tokyo with Love? 10. I'm not even counting these pages or yesterday. No, it's ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. It's fine. I'm hoping to read more today. I'm hoping to finish my first draft today for my essay, and I also have to finish editing my video. It's so sad. Like, I wanted to upload a video yesterday about all the Asian books that are on my TBR, and it's not done editing. Like, I'm halfway through it and then I have to caption it, so I don't know when it's going to be up, but it's fine. I will live with this. And yeah, I'm just going to keep on working. I'm going to work in my bed. I'm just very tired. It's a gloomy day. So I'm wearing pink. I love pink. What can I say? My hair looks like a mess. It's completely fine. But yeah, I'm going to have my little coffee and get to work. So it's 2:18 and I finished writing my reflective essay. So good job, Romy, now you can edit your video. Yeah, amazing. So I might take a break and go and have a white hot chocolate at Costa, because it's 5 minutes away from where I live. I don't think I will stay there, but I still want to move a little bit. Also, I wanted to let you know that I started this book, which is a history book in French about Vietnam. It's quite small and I have a big book about Vietnam in English that's in my book out, but I thought, why not start first with a small one, go through it quite quickly, and then continue with the big stuff. And I'm on page 14. Hopefully I will like it. I love knowing more about Vietnam. If you don't know, my dad's family is from Vietnam, so it's pretty dear to my heart. Yeah. So, I don't know why, but this book got water damaged a little bit. Don't know what happened. It's fine. It's going to survive. I can still read it. Okay, so, Costa, editing, and maybe some reading after. Wouldn't that be wild to be reading in a reading vlog? Sorry, I'm tired. I don't know where the day's gone. It's nearly 7 p.m. and I'm tired. Did I mention that I'm tired? Okay, it's Monday. I was about to say it's Tuesday, but no, it's Monday. This morning, I submitted my reflective essay and also submitted my part of the group project. So it means that I had most of the afternoon to relax. I just captioned my video that's going up tomorrow. That's what I did. It's a lot of fun. I totally recommend it. But I wanted to update you on what I read yesterday. So I read 100 pages of From Little Tokyo With Love in less than an hour. I had not expected that at all, but I'm having so much fun. Basically, you're following this girl, Rika, and she lives with her two aunts and her two cousins, and she's lived with them since she was born. And she's always been told that her mom died. And then one day you have this movie star who sees her at a Japanese American parade. Basically, maybe her mom isn't dead. So that's a big premise of the book, I guess. But the reason why I'm liking this book so much this far is because Rika is mixed race. She's half white, half Japanese. The biracial representation is already so good. Breaking my heart a little bit, but already so good. And also, Rika suffers from anger issues. As someone who is angry 90% of the time, this is so relatable. So relatable. So yeah, I'm very much liking it so far. And at the back, I see that Akemi Dunbowman and Helen Wong have blurbed it. So Akemi Dunbowman, who wrote Starfish, which is one of my favorite books ever, said that this novel is a beautiful love letter to biracial kids that's full of longing, hope and so much heart. I agree. And then we have Helen Wang, who wrote The Kiss Quotient, which is one of my all-time favorite books. And she said, to mixed race readers especially, this one's for you. Yeah, I'm having an amazing time reading this book so far. I'm hoping to read another 100 pages tonight. That would be lovely. And I read a bit more of my history book, so I'm 40 pages in, still liking it. I feel like it's not one to read if you don't know much about Vietnam history, because they use a lot of technical words, but it's still good. It's 5:45 and I just got home from a study date with a friend and I still managed to get some books. I think that's the problem when you go into a coffee shop that's in a bookshop. I got 4 books. There was a buy 3 for $2 deal and then I got another one, and you're going to laugh when you see the selection of books I have, because I laughed when I realized what was going on. So I got all these books from Blackpink. So the first one that isn't part of my deal is The Light of the Midnight Stars. So I read The Sisters of the Winter Wood by Rena Wassner. I love everything Jewish, we all know, and this one is also Jewish and it's going to probably make me cry. It takes place in Hungary, so I'm excited. The cover is just spectacular if you ask me. Even the back, it's gorgeous. Ooh, the inside is pretty though. We love it. So yeah, I saw it, I grabbed it, couldn't not buy it, honestly. I feel like all the books I got are new releases. Okay, no, this one is The Bonechild Daughter and it's the paperback. The paperback was released, I think last month, but the hardback was released last year. I'm excited, I love this cover. I would have preferred the hardback, but I basically got it for free. I saw the 2 other books and I really wanted them. These are 2 books that I have been looking for since bookshops reopened here in Scotland. I basically thought might as well get a 3rd one, and well, here it is. And then for the other 2 we have The Unbroken. This cover is incredible. I think the main character is a lesbian. We love it. She looks so badass. Please walk over me. It was on my list of books I wanted, so excited. And the final one, I'm so excited for it. It's The Midnight Bargain. And look at this cover. It's incredible. I'm absolutely in love with it. How was it described to me? Was it described as a sort of Bridgerton twist? The Midnight Bargain is a sweeping magical Regency fantasy from world fantasy award-winning author C.L. Brooke. Honestly, it just looks really good to me. Yeah, I'm excited. So, I don't know if you've seen the theme going on here, but all of these books are from the same publishing company. They're all from Orbit. And I just realized it at the end when I when I had all of them in my hands. And for a little update about From Little Tokyo with Love, I'm on page 194, so nearly halfway through it. I'm hoping to finish it during this vlog. So I'm finishing this vlog on Friday night, so I still have 2 days. So I will be able to do this. I'm really liking it. I think it's very much for biracial kids. There are many discussions about being biracial, about wanting to fit in, about wanting to be more Asian, and about being rejected by all your communities. It's hurting me so badly, and I love every single second of it. It reads so quickly, and I'm taking a lot of notes for my dissertation. Not even just for my dissertation, but just quotes that just hurt me in the feels. But these are also quotes I think I will be able to use for my dissertation. It's just really good. It's really good. It's going in a different direction than if I would go when I read the first 100 pages, but I'm not mad. There is this quote that just hurt me. But do you ever feel, well, not quite part of it? Because when I think about my experiences with communities that should be mine, I also feel like maybe I'm not welcome, like I'm not enough, you know? It's almost like you're seen as someone who can never really belong anywhere. You're a watered down diet version of something else. Like a fraction, a thing to be claimed only if the community deems you worthy. As if I could never be a whole version of anything. I just want to be able to exist as myself, you know? Not someone who has to be described using fractions. Just a whole you. Yeah. Hi, it's 10 to 11. I'm currently drinking coffee and trying to get started on my essay. I don't know why I cannot seem to focus on this stupid reflection essay. Like, it should be easy because it's just about my experience, about my feelings. But I don't know why my brain just doesn't want to focus on this, and it's so hard to put my thoughts into words. But yeah, I have to do it. I have four days. Saying this out loud, it just sounds so ridiculous. I just have to do it. Like, I have no other choice. I have to do it. And I don't know why my brain's like, no, we don't want to do this. But yeah, I didn't end up reading anything yesterday, because my brain was just all over the place. Today, I'm going to vote, which is exciting. Also, sorry, look at my new phone case with my new pop socket. I love it. Anyway, yes, it's 10. I washed my hair, woke up at 8:30, something like that, and now I'm waiting for my supervisor for my internship to come and give me some books to promote for Instagram. She's coming at 10:30, something like that, so what I want to do is read a bit more until she arrives. So I'm on page 275, which means I have 140 pages left to read. So because I was able to work really well on my essay yesterday, I'm a bit more than 1,000 words into my essay. I feel like I can take a bit more time to finish this book today. I'm pretty pleased with what I've written so far from my essay. It's coming along nicely. It's a lot of work. I'm just glad I'm getting work done and that I'm not behind on my personal deadlines, because, well, I wanted to have at least 1,000 words done for yesterday, so I'm on track. And yeah, I'm just going to drink my little coffee. It's vanilla coffee with almond milk. So it's 11:27 and I just wanted to show you something very exciting. So this is fake news, and this is the book I did a typeset for. Basically, the typeset is getting the book ready to be printed, so creating paragraph styles and things like that. So this is the first book I helped creating. It's here in my hands. I'm so happy. Look at it. Oh my gosh. It comes out on May 31st, so I will leave a link to the website if you want to pre-order it. This is the synopsis if you want to pause and read. But yes, I'm excited. That's all I wanted to say. I haven't started working yet. I've just read 20 pages. This is my boba. This is my pajama. This is a mess, but it's fine. This is the end of the vlog. Oh my gosh, I don't know what time it is. 6, something like that. I finished it. I liked it so much. It wasn't what I had expected, that's for sure. But I'm so glad I gave this book a try. It truly took me by surprise. I started this book not knowing what it was about, and somehow this book ended up being exactly what I needed. The way this book discusses being biracial, the way your community can both love you and hurt you at the same time, and also the way we keep on hurting biracial kids and just people who are different in our communities just because we are set in our own ways. I think this book has very important things to say, and I'm glad that it's YA, because it means that more young people will be able to get their hands on this and be able to see that they are not alone in their own feelings, that they are not alone in their anger, in their loneliness, and maybe, just maybe, they don't have to feel so angry and they don't have to feel so alone. And I wish I had this book as a teen. I so wish had added. Yeah, I very much enjoyed this book. I did not like the insta love, but that's my own preference. I don't like insta love. I would have wished that it would have been a bit more developed. Maybe if it hadn't taken place during 1 week, maybe a month. I just feel like maybe the romance happened too quickly, but that's my own personal preference, as I said. But I enjoy all the characters. I loved Rika. I saw so much of myself in her, in her loneliness and anger and confusion and hurt. But I also very much adored Henry. He was such a soft boy. He was pure and he was so good. He deeply believed in everybody's good heart, and that's something I love. I just really, really enjoyed him, and I loved Rika's family. Like, even though when you start the book, you feel like they don't truly understand her, it's important to remember that you're seeing this story through Rika's eyes, and Rika herself doesn't feel like she truly belongs. But the more you spend time with her, the more you spend time with a family, you see that they all feel this way in a way. Like, they all had their own insecurities. I don't know if it's a 4.25 or a 4.5. I haven't put it through Copilot yet. To wrap up this vlog, I read this book in its entirety, and I read 55 pages of my history book on Vietnam, and I'm pretty happy with myself. I'm writing an essay, and I was writing another essay when I started this vlog, so I was pretty busy, and I got to read this book that's 420 something pages and 50 pages from another book. So I read nearly 500 pages this week, which is pretty amazing. Yes, I did only read one book, and my TBR is fucking long, but I had other things to do, and I very much enjoyed this book, so I'm pretty happy with how this week went. I'm hoping to upload this vlog on Monday, which will be the 10th, and this book is being released on the 11th, so if this book sounds like something you like, maybe you should give it a try. And I will leave in the description the Goodreads link for this book. But yes, that's going to be it for this video. So if you liked it, please give it a thumbs up. That would make me very happy. And if you're not subscribed yet, maybe you can. Of course, only if you want. And if you want to be notified for whenever I post a new video, click on the little bell. And I hope you will have an amazing rest of your day. Please remember that you're loved, and I will see you in another video. Bye.